101. Yeah, length is okay. And go back for the assembly of matrix. So now the four pieces. So this is the same L11, L12. I'm individually constructing the pieces of stiffness matrix. So this stiffness matrix K, capital K, is divided into four pieces. First piece is having n plus 1, the order of the matrix. Similarly for the others, rest thing will be the same. So you need not to be change anything for this. And here you have to be construct the same values. This will be also the same. The issue is that when you are constructing this, I have now constructed the four different small k's so that I can update my capital L11 accordingly. This is for the known conditions, so no issue. So this is K11 for the coefficient of U for the first equation. K11 is the coefficient of V for the second equation. For the first equation. This both is for the first equation. So I can extend it that. So I can write comment here for you that for first equation. So this is for second equation. Obviously this K21 is the coefficient of U for the second equation. This coefficient of V for the second equation. And this right hand side is F11, F12 I have written here. There I have written right R. So main capital is R1 to R2. And this is for the component wise. So when you are going to with the connectivity matrix, obviously you can connect each entry one by one by this directivity matrix. The idea is the same for the 1D system. I am not extending this. I am just constructing the matrix now this piece wise. Complete K will not easy to construct. This L11, L12, four pieces are now been constructed. Similarly, R1, R2 is constructed. So boundary condition implementation is also according to this pieces. So when you see that, and you go back to this, for the district condition, if you maintained U0 is 0, so you have to see that in the first equation, U0 is 0. So this is the KL11 is for U. So you have to be make the first row 0 for only for L11 and keep the diagonal element 1. Last row is 0 and keep the diagonal element 1 so that your entry will be fixed by 0 and 1. So when you go to here, need not to touch L12, but you have to make the zero of row for all the entries. Means you have to make zeros for L11 first row, all zeros. L12 first row, all zero. But to make the diagonal element 1, you have to be go for this only, because diagonal is present only in L11. Similarly, you have to be make all rows of first elements of all rows, keeping it make it a 0. Similarly for the last element, make it a 0, and for the last entry of this and the first entry of this, means the diagonal entries, to make the for the implementation of Dirichlet boundary condition of V, you have to be make it 1 and substitute the value of that entries to the right side so that it will be satisfied automatically. So this is the important thing for the implementation of the boundary condition. So so everything is explained here. I have made the first row 0, first row 0, and here last row 0, last row 0. So when you see here, the entries are in such a way that first and last rows is kept as a 0. Similarly for the second, mean L22 or L21. So similarly, and now this is for the implementation of Dirichlet, keeping one both side and substitute the values to the right side. Now I can go merge all this to the single K, and also all right hand side to the single R, and finally the D means solution is constructed. Now important thing, that the first n plus 1 elements of D is the your solution is U. So you have to be, now your output is the entire this column, and the dimensions is 2n plus 2. So you have to be split it in two pieces. So I'm going to split it from 1 to nn. Nn is actually n plus 1. So nn 1 plus 2, 2 into nn. So this is the solution. So this is for the single update, and this is the same thing which I've already explained to you for the Gaussian quadrature formula, which has already been applied to, already been discussed in my earlier videos. So you can watch that videos for better understanding. So when go back, so this will reach here, and automatically this process will run when the two values will be the same, or two value will be the same as the accuracy maintained. So I have kept this accuracy 0.005, so 4 decimal accurate. So you can just run this code to check. So firstly, I have run this code only for 5 elements. So there is issue with, I have changed this. So just go back, just check the error. Yeah, this will be, should be a V. Earlier I have taken another symbol, now it's actually a V. So entirely UV is taken, and I'll run this. Yeah. Graph is there, figure 1, figure 2, this is exponential, 1 and 2.7, this is parabolic, 1 and 1, 0 and 1. Yeah, this is, graph is, seems to be okay. Now let's check the results. Oh, this is system is, now I have to run this again. Yeah. So X is the element, 0 to 1 domain, total 5 element is mean actually the 6 nodes. So this is your FEM solution, negative, don't bother about this negative sign, it's actually a 0. So this is the values, this is the exact solutions, because I know the solution X here, how to substitute the value of X here. This is for the second, this is for exact for exponential. The error is more in case of X here. So no issue. So in order to decrease the error, either you go for the quadratic or higher order, otherwise method is simple, just extend the values of n, means take the number of nodes, more number of nodes, more number of elements. So I'm taking a 10, it's almost 4 decimal accurate, and this is 3 decimal accurate. When go to 100, so you can see that the error is 0. It means that it's exactly 4 decimal accurate. So 100 elements is not an issue. So when I go to the 2D system, you can see that you have to be take at least 10,000 elements to have a better accuracy. Because when you go to a 2D system, the system is complex. The number of nodes, you have to take the more number of nodes for the nonlinear. If you are dealing with a linear, then it's okay. The number of nodes is not an issue. So if you have a system nonlinearity, like for a differential equation, so in order to run the code, you have to take, for more accuracy, you have to take the more number of elements. So this is all about today's lecture, and if you have any question, you can ask me via my mail scientificrana@gmail.com, and for more videos, you have to subscribe my channel for the Scientific Rana. So have a good day.